effects of video gaming. Big plagues on our civilization. I'm talking about global civilization. This is a multi-billion dollar industry with massive resources and power now. This is incredibly harmful. It's addict. People die from this. There was a Japanese boy who gamed until he had a heart attack. People die from this. It's true there are only a small number of people that are going to get addicted in that way. This is what Islam is, a rahmah to people. So it prohibits things that are harmful. Anybody who studied fiqh knows there's a section on bi'ah. It's prohibited to sell alatu lahu. It's haram to sell games. You can make your own games, you know, like play games, children play games, rocks and stones. Little kids, they don't care what you give them. But to sell things and make money off lahu is prohibited in our sharia. Nobody talks about this anymore. They just think, oh, you can just go and do this and it doesn't matter. You know, this is what's happened to us because shaitan has taken us by steps. So if you look at these things, social isolation, drop in school performance, obesity, people that game are fatter than people that don't, wasting time, which is a great sin in our religion, to waste our time. It's sinful to waste time. Violent tendencies, we know this. Financial loss, decrease in empathy, you become less empathic. Average age of these players, 35 years old. What are you doing? Seriously, 35 years old is the average. There was a game called Tetris. And I had never done this before. So I started playing it. And it was really interesting. And I was, oh, okay. And I worked it out. And I don't even know how long I played it for. When I finished, I turned away and I was seeing those images come down. I never did it again. And my wife would testify, I don't play any of those games. I've never played any of those games. I am against those games. They're evil games. And I really encourage you just to give them up and utilize your time. Learn a language. Go talk to the Orang Asli about Islam. You know, go clean up. Get volunteer groups that do litter pickup on your streets, you know. Seriously, go do something useful. Go play soccer. Go visit your grandmother. Go to a hospital and visit people that aren't getting people visiting them. Do something useful, but don't waste your time doing this. 49% are 18 to 49 year olds. 25% less than 18 year old. 26% are over 50 years old. So this is Ammat al-Balwa. Look at the physical fight. Gamers, 40% of females have been in a physical fight in America, 51% of males. Look at the non-gamers, 14% as opposed to 28%. You know, and they'll say, oh, but you can't prove any correlation, right? You can't prove it. You don't need a rocket scientist to just know the obvious. Poor grades, females, almost 40%. 35% of the males, as opposed to 20% and 23%. No relationship though, no correlation, can't prove it. Damaged property, 15% of the gamers, 23%. This is people going out and damaging property. In other words, delinquency. 5% of females, 10% of males, which is still high, I think. 89% of top-selling video games contain violent content. Half of it is of a serious nature. Highly criticized video game, Grand Theft Auto, which was actually developed by some criminals. They were real criminals, drug dealers. They came up with this idea. You get points by killing policemen. Look at this industry. He takes you by steps. This is 2008. It was almost $12 billion. It's a lot of power. When you have that kind of money, you can buy judges, you can lobby people, you can do immense things.
Unfortunately, the most popular video games, even among very young kids, are the ones that reward you for doing violence against others. And when you think of the fact that people sat in front of a flight simulator and learned to fly planes well enough to bring the World Trade Towers to the ground, and we're putting our kids for fun in front of essentially killing simulators, where are we going with that? We have to really recognize the fact that there are changes in their minds and their thinking and their behavior that are going to come of that. If there weren't changes from media, from entertainment, we wouldn't do it. So we need to go into these processes with our eyes open, understanding that we are changing our children, we are changing ourselves, and we should make sure that the changes that are happening are ones that we want.
Video games do, in fact, and are designed to affect the empathy level, the moral compass of children, especially, and adults. And that made me quit, because I am supporting, I am creating the content to destroy children's empathy and adults. I'm creating the content and the sounds to make demons come to life. Why am I doing this? This is not who I am. I don't know if people can really relate to that or grasp that, but that is my story. That is how I quit, because I could not be a part of what I was creating to further destroy whatever moral compass is left in people. I tell you this, my opinion, nobody should allow their children to play any video games. Well, nobody should allow their children to have a phone or watch TV. If you look at who's supporting the games, who's you know, there's military games specifically created by the military, which are often war games. There's sometimes it's sponsored by CIA. Sometimes it's, you know, just depend. You should look at who's actually giving money for these games. And so you ask, you know, where's that coming from? Somewhere in that mix, there is some agent in between these companies and government telling them what to do. Now, I can't point to a specific agency or whatever, but it's kind of obvious when you understand that aspect of it, that everything happens because government says it does. Just to give you an example, why would you want to play something like Call of Duty? Why would you want to pick up a gun and shoot people in a pretend fashion? Why would you want to? What is it that drives us to find that amusing or fun?
Study after study after study have shown that the rating systems consistently underestimate the potency of what is being presented in that media. A second problem for me as a pediatrician, as a child health researcher, and as a parent is that they are not scientifically based, nor are they concerned about the outcomes of exposure to this. What they're concerned about is social acceptability of this material. So, for example, in the movie rating systems, you'll get an R rating for showing a naked person, but you will only get a PG or a PG-13 for disemboweling a person. And it teaches that it is not only acceptable or normative to do things like that, but that that should be enjoyable because we're here, after all, for fun. So unfortunately, the rating systems have to be seen for what they are. They will tell you increasing severity of whatever it is they're rating, but it's increasing severity for social acceptability reasons, not for reasons of the child's health or well-being.
I order the forces of darkness to pour its infernal power over me. Let the gates of hell open wide. And from the abyss, greet me as your brother and friend. I order everything to be as I command. I desire to destroy this world. If I cannot rule the world of men, then no one will!
I know that symbol. That's a Phrygian cap. It stands for freedom, and that's a Masonic eye. Now those two come together in only one place.
What's happening? I can't believe...
Why do they call this Dark Messiah? This is a game. And why does Dark Messiah, which is Messiah, it's the Messiah al-Muzlim, why does this Dark Messiah have one eye? Who's inspiring them? They might not know what they're doing, but Shaitan is inspiring them to do this because he's preparing people.
I have traveled through time to warn you. This is my past, but your future. And it means the end of humanity, so together, we must change it!
Foundation that brought out fear. Fear.
You're paying these little streams of a dollar to the game company, and it turns out the companies make tons more money in that model than they ever did back in the day.